In this video, I'm going to show you how you can speed ramp inside Adobe After Effects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Here we go! So I'm inside Adobe After Effects and I have a composition pulled up with a clip of a snowboarder. And if we play this back, what I want to do is keyframe it and speed ramp it so it starts normal. It speeds up when he goes up in the air, then it slows down for a little bit, and that speeds up as he comes down and lands. So I'm going to show you how you can work with the time remapping controls inside After Effects to achieve that look. Now I got this clip from Artlist, but if you want to follow along, feel free to use your own clip. You should be able to use any of the techniques I show in this video. So the first thing that you have to do is enable time remapping. And to do that, you can click on your clip in the timeline, right click, and go to Time, Enable Time Remapping. There is also a keyboard shortcut, Option Command T, so you can click that as well or create a custom keyboard shortcut if you do want to set that up. And once we have that selected, you'll notice that the time remap controls come up here with two keyframes, one at the beginning and one at the end. And now we can go forward out in time and determine when we want to speed up and slow down our clips. If you watched my Premiere Pro speed ramping tutorial, it's kind of similar to that. So maybe around the 2 second mark, this is when I want to start speeding up my clip. So I'm going to click on the diamond to make a keyframe, and then around 3 seconds, right here, he should be up in the air. So in order to get him up in the air there, what I'm going to do is click and drag this to the right, this value, this is essentially the time or the time code. And I want to get him up in the air right around there is good. Then I want him to hang there up in the air for about 2 seconds. So I'm going to go out to about 5 seconds or so, make a keyframe by clicking on this diamond. And then around 6 seconds, he should be back on the ground. So once again, I'm going to click and drag this to the right and get him right to the ground right when he touches. That'll look cool on playback. So that's how to set up speed ramping. If we click and play this back, we can see he starts normal, speeds up, slows down, and then speeds up again as he lands and it goes back down to normal. So that's the first step. The next step is to add some easy ease. You can tell, you know, it's very linear, it's very rigid, so we can ease in and out of these different motions to make it more smooth. So to do that, what I'm going to do is right click on this first keyframe here, and we're going to add an easy ease out. So we're easing out of the first keyframe, and then here we're going to add a easy ease keyframe by right clicking and going to keyframe assistant, easy ease. And same with the last one, we're going to right click and go to keyframe assistant, easy ease. This enables us to adjust the easing for these three keyframes here. And really the beginning and the end, we don't really need to add easing, but you can if you wish. And then to fine tune the easing, we can turn on our graph editor. So if we click on this button, we can click on our parameter inside the timeline panel and you'll see this appear. Now I do recommend making this a little larger, so I'm gonna expand my workspace here. Now by default, we're looking at the value graph and you should be able to switch it to speed graph if you want by clicking on this button and going to speed graph. Now personally, I like the value graph, so I'm going to stay in the value graph. This just makes more sense. This displays the value of the time code over time as it starts at 0 seconds at the bottom left and it goes up to 15 seconds at the top. All right, so let's get started here. What we can do first, if we click on one of these keyframes, you can see these are the keyframes, the little yellow boxes here. We click on this first one, we have these handlebars that appear. We can adjust this by clicking up and dragging so we can adjust the easing. And this will just take some practice over time to adjust and kind of see what works best for you. But for now, I'm just gonna adjust these. And you'll wanna do something that kind of looks like this. And I'll kind of zoom in, I'll go full screen and kind of explain what's happening. So as we start at the bottom left here, we're kind of slowly speeding up. And then it kind of slows down and it kind of slows down during this point at between this keyframe and this keyframe. And remember, this is the value over time. So this is how the time code is changing over time. So you want to kind of make sure this constantly changes, but that it is dynamic in a way that kind of looks like this. I'm gonna adjust this so it kind of eases out of this keyframe and kind of goes up into the last keyframe. So it should look something like this if you are doing a clip similar to mine. When we click and play this back, we can see what we have. So it kind of slows down and then it speeds up at the end and then it stops. Now you can adjust these two. I should mention, say if you want that part, the slow motion part, to be faster, You can click on this keyframe, hold down shift and click on the last keyframe, and move these to the left to speed up that slow part if you want that to go faster. So you can always move these keyframes around depending how your clip looks. You can see we sped up that slow motion part a little bit. You can always just click and drag these keyframes around if you want to adjust, you know, how fast and slow the ramping is. But for now, that looks pretty good. The next part, now that we have that, and depending how it looks on your own footage, you might notice that it might be jittery. If you want to turn on frame blending, you can. That is the switch right here. If you click on it twice, this will turn on pixel blending here. If you don't see that option, you can click on this button at the bottom left to expand and collapse the layer switches pane. And once you click that, this should appear here. The last thing we can do, just to add some more realistic effect to this, we can add motion blur. So if we click on our clip, we can go into our effects and presets and we can type in for pixel motion blur. You can see I have it right here. You can click and drag this onto your clip. You'll notice that this adds just some realistic motion blur as the clip gets sped up here. So in the end, this is what we have. Starts slow, speeds up, slows down, and speeds up again at the end. So that's how to set up speed ramps inside Adobe After Effects. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments section below. It just takes some time to get used to how the graph editor works. And if you do want to learn more about the graph editor, I did make a video dedicated to explaining all the controls inside of it. I will link that video right up there if you do want to check that out. But that does it for this video. I hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you guys next time. Take care.